Good morning, students. As we have already started and finished also the chapter circle, that is chapter 10. So exercise up to exercise 10.3, I think you already did. I have given you classwork, so you know how to do. So today I'm going to show you from exercise 10.4, that is question number 2. So you see, here is the question. Question number 2, what is given? If two equal chords of a circle intersect within the circle, prove that the segments of one chord are equal to the corresponding segment of other chord. Okay, now here it is, the solution which I have sent you already. That first of all, you know, the first part is you have to write the given. So here you have written given. Now what is written in given? Here is one circle. Here A, B and C, D are two chords which are intersecting each other at the point E. Okay, now here you have to prove that the segments, here the segment means the two parts of the chord. After intersecting at E, you are getting two parts. One is AE, another is BE. And again, for the chord CD, you are getting two parts, that is CE and ED. Now we are going to prove that the corresponding segments are equal. That means AE equals to DE and CE equals to BE. Okay, now let's see how to prove it. It is very easy. Now first of all, for construction, one thing you have to draw, that ON is perpendicular. ON is perpendicular to CD and OM is perpendicular to AB. These two lines we have drawn, two perpendiculars we have drawn. Okay, and we have joined OE also. Now you know, here so many theorems already have told you to write related to the circle chapter, and already you got in class 8 also, that perpendicular drawn from the center bisect the chord. So OM is a perpendicular which is drawn on the chord AB, so it is bisect the chord. That means we'll get, bisect means two equal parts, AM equals to BM. So here you have written, since OM is perpendicular to AB and ON is perpendicular to CD, therefore M and N are the midpoints of the AB and CD respectively. So in that way, you can write M equals to half of AB and DN equals to half of CD. We are giving here number 1. Now again, you see that these two chords, which chords are intersecting each other inside the circle, these two chords are equal, as it is given here, two equal chords. So as it is AB equals to CD given, these two chords are equal, so half of AB is equals to half of CD. Now half of AB we have already written equals to AM, so and half of CD we have written here DN, so AM equals to DN from 1, and here I am giving here name as 2. Now in triangle OME and ONE, now you see these two triangles OME and ONE, these two triangles we are going to prove these two triangles are congruent. How? You see OE is the common side, and you know the equal chords are equidistant from the center. This is one of your theorem, equal chords are equidistant from the center. So OM is the distance of AB chord from the center, and ON also distance from the CD chord from the center. So since AB and CD are equal, therefore OM and equals to ON, and these two are right angles. So in the with the help of RHS, here you have written here that OME and ON each 90 degree, OM equals to ON, equal chords are equidistant from the center, OE equals to OE common side. So these two triangles are congruent with the help of right RHS. Therefore we can prove that M equals to NE. So since these two triangles are congruent, therefore we can write M equals to NE. Already we have proved AM equals to DN. Now we are proving M equals to NE. Here M equals to NE. Now adding 2 and 3, AM plus ME, you know, left hand side plus left hand side, right hand side plus right hand side we have done. Now you see AM plus ME, what you are getting? AE. And DN plus NE, we are getting DE. So in that way, we have proved AE equals to DE. Again, we have written AB is equals to CD given. Now, AB minus AE, you know, same thing, you can subtract from Euclid postulate. sorry axiom in a form equal Euclid axiom, you know that equal things are subtracted from equal. So AB minus AE, CD minus AE. Again AB minus AE, and you know AE equals to DE already written. So in place of this AE we have written DE from 4. This is 4 and this is 4. So AB minus AE, what we'll get? Full is AB. From here if you'll subtract AE, then what part will get? BE. So here you're getting BE is equals to CE similarly. So hence we prove A equals to D and B equals to CE. Understand? Now next question is question number 4, which one I have sent you. Here it is given that if a line, the question is what? If a line intersect two concentric circles. Concentric circles means circle with the same center, with center O at A, B, C, D. Prove that AB equals to CD. So here I have drawn two circles which center is same, that is O, and one line is intersecting these two circles at, and it intersect A, B, C and D. These three, four points it intersect. Now we are going to prove that what we have to prove here? We have to prove here that AB equals to CD. I have not written, so you please you write it to prove AB equals to AB is equals to CD. This one we have to prove. Now for that we have to construct OM, one perpendicular we have drawn on this line AB. Now again the same theorem we are going to prove. We are going to use that since perpendicular drawn from the center bisect the chord, therefore we have construct a perpendicular, and we have written, and we are getting, if you consider this inner circle, then here you will get BM equals to MC, because this is a perpendicular and this is BC is the chord for the inner circle and AD is the chord for the outer circle. So since this is a perpendicular drawn from the center, so it bisects the inner circle's chord as well as outer circle chord. So here in that we will get AM equals to MD and BM equals to MC. Here you have written, you see AM equals to DM and BM equals to CM. Okay. Now we'll subtract from 1, 2 from 1. So AM minus BM equals to DM minus CM. You see AM minus BM, so what will get? AB portion will get, and DM minus CM, what will get? In which portion will get? CD portion will get. So equals to CD. Hence proved. Now one more maths I want to show you, as the video is too long becoming. Then also you see today again I will send you this question. As I have what question solution I have sent you, that is from your previous book, and that book the names are different. Okay, here I have seen just now the in new book the names are different. That is three girls, there something Mary, something different given, and here it is given different. So once again you note down this. Let Razia, Mary and Ilakshi are denoted by R, M and S respectively. Now question, what is the question? First you see the question. What is given in the question? Three girls, Rajya, Mary and Ilakshi, are playing a game by the standing on a circle of radius 5 meter drawn in a park. Rajya throw a ball to Mary, Mary to Nilakshi, Nilakshi to Rajya. If the distance between Rajya, Mary and and between the Mary and Nilakshi is 6 meter each, what is the distance between Rajya and Nilakshi? Now here is, you see here Razia, Mary and Ilakshi, these three girls are sitting on the circumference on of the circle, and the distance between Razia and Mary, Mary and Ilakshi is 6 meter, and the radius of the circle is 5 meter. These things are given. Now you have to find out the distance between Razia and Ilakshi. So how will find out? So here what was given, I have written, as it is given RM equals to MN equals to 6 meter, MO is the radius of the circle, R also radius of the circle is 5 meter. So as you see, this is a triangle, isn't it? It is a triangle, and you know it's a Hero's formula you can use, and again you find out the area of the triangle. So in that way we are finding out the area of the triangle. So as you know, A, this side is A, this B, and this side is C, you can consider and you can find out, and we are getting 12 m square. Now, again, you know, another formula of the to find out the area of the triangle is half into base into altitude. So in this triangle, this is a perpendicular, we are considering perpendicular, how it is a perpendicular. Now, as it is a center, and this center, from this center, we have drawn one perpendicular, which will bisect the chord. You know, this is a perpendicular. From the center, if you draw a perpendicular, that will bisect the chord, and this is the perpendicular. So, since it is a perpendicular, it's a 90 degree, this is also perpendicular. Now, so half into, this is the base, MO is the base, and RP is the perpendicular. We have considered in that way also it's a perpendicular, in this way also it is a perpendicular. Now, so we have written half into OM equals to OM into RP. So half OM we know 5, RP we don't know, so RP we are keeping, and in that way we are finding out RP. RP, what we are getting RP? RP we are getting after calculation 4.8 meter. Now, you know, since perpendicular drawn from the center bisect the chord, so Rn is the twice of RP. So Rn is the twice of RP. So 2 into 4.8 equals to 9.6 meter. Okay. So today this much only. So next tomorrow I'll give you solution of the next questions. Okay. Thank you.